After studying this module, you shall be able to know why Mendel chose pea plant for his research, how Mendel carried out his research, what are the conclusions drawn from Mendel's research, what are the exceptions of Mendel laws. Mendelian genetics. Mendelian inheritance is inheritance of biological features that follows the laws proposed by Gregor John Mendel in 1865 and 1866 and rediscovered in 1900. It was initially very controversial. When Mendel's theories were integrated with the chromosome theory of inheritance by Thomas Hunt Morgan in 1915, they became the core of classical genetics. The laws of inheritance were derived by Gregor Mendel, a 19th century Australian monk conducting hybridization experiments in garden peas, Pisum sativum, he planted in the backyard of the church. Between 1856 and 1863, he cultivated and tested some 5,000 pea plants. From these experiments, he induced two generalizations, which later became known as Mendel's principles of heredity or Mendelian inheritance. He described these principles in a two-part paper, Experiments on Plant Hybridization, that he read to the Natural History Society of Brno on February 8 and March 8, 1865, and which was published in 1866. Mendel's conclusions were largely ignored. A major block to understanding their significance was the importance attached by 19th century biologists to the apparent blending of inherited traits in the overall appearance of the progeny, now known to be due to multi-gene interactions, in contrast to the organ-specific binary characters studied by Mendel. In 1900, however, his work was rediscovered by three European scientists, Hugo de Vries, Carl Correns, and Erik von Teschermack. Mendel's findings allowed other scientists to predict the expression of traits on the basis of mathematical probabilities. A large contribution to Mendel's success can be traced to his decision to start his crosses only with plants he demonstrated were true breeding. He also only measured absolute or binary characteristics such as color, shape, and position of the offspring, rather than quantitative characteristics. He expressed his results numerically and subjected them to statistical analysis. His method of data analysis and his large sample size gave credibility to his data. He also had the foresight to follow several successive generations, F2, F3, of pea plants and record their variations. Finally, he performed test crosses, that is, backcrossing descendants of the initial hybridization to the initial true breeding lines to reveal the presence and proportion of recessive characters.
Let us now understand this module with the help of visuals and graphics. Mendel's experimental approach. Mendel's research was with the pea, that is, Pisum sativum, which began in 1856 in his own monastery garden. The success of Mendel's work was because of following reasons. First is selection of single character. Second, keeping accurate record of each plant. And third, mathematical analysis of data. Mendel selected pea plant because of the following reasons. First is, they are easy to grow. Second, easy to get in large number. Third, available in many variety. And thus, traits are easy to isolate. Next, reproduce sexually. And the last, they have male and female sex cells called gametes. Mendel discovered that when he crossed purebred white flower and purple flower P plants, the parental or P generation, the result was not a blend, rather than being a mix of the two. The offspring known as the FN generation was purple flowered. When Mendel self-fertilized the FN generation P plants, he obtained a purple flower to white flower ratio in the F2 generation of 3:1. He then conceived the idea of heredity units, which he called factors. Mendel found that there are alternative forms of factors, now called genes, that account for variations in heredity characteristics. For example, the gene for flower color in pea plants exists in two forms, one for purple and the other for white. The alternative forms are now called alleles. For each biological trait, an organism inherits two alleles, one from each parent. These alleles may be the same or different. An organism that has two identical alleles for a gene is said to be homozygous for that gene and is also known as homozygote. An organism has two different alleles for a gene is said to be heterozygous for that gene and it is also said as heterozygote. Mendel also hypothesized that allele pairs separate randomly or segregate from each other during the reproduction of gametes, that is, egg and sperm. Because allele pairs separate during gamete production, a sperm or egg carries only one allele for each inherited trait. When sperm and egg unite at fertilization, each contributes its allele, restoring the paired condition in the offspring. This is known as law of segregation. Mendel also found that each pair of alleles segregates independently of other pair of allele during gamete formation. This is known as the law of independent assortment. The genotype of an individual is made up of the many alleles it possesses. An individual's physical appearance or phenotype is determined by its alleles as well as by its environment. The presence of an allele does not mean that the trait will be expressed in the individual that possesses it. If the two alleles of an inherited pair differ, that is the condition of heterozygous, then one determines the organism's appearance and is called the dominant allele. The other has no noticeable effect on the organism's appearance and is known as the recessive allele. Thus, in the example, dominant purple flower allele will hide the phenotypic effect of the recessive white flower allele. This is known as the law of dominance, but it is not a transmission law. Dominance has to do with the expression of the genotype and not its transmission. Seven traits studied by Mendel. Basically, Seven traits were studied by Mendel in pea plant, which are: first is sea coat, color or flower, that is gray and purple. Second, seed color, yellow and green. Next, seed shape, that is smooth and wrinkled. Pod color, green and yellow. Pod shape, inflated and pinched. Stem height, tall and short. And flower position, that is axil and terminal. Mendel's data. The output of Mendel's research work. Mendel crossed round and wrinkled seed. He obtained round seed in F1 generation, which means round traits is dominant over wrinkled trait. The probability ratio obtained in F1 generation is 3:1 for round and wrinkled seed. In the same manner, remaining traits of pea plants were crossed. One allele in each pair was dominant over the other pair. For all remaining 6 traits, probability ratio obtained was 3:1. The various antagonistic traits of pea plant which Mendel used for his research are: the round seed shape is dominant, whereas wrinkled seed shape is recessive. Yellow seed color is dominant, whereas green seed color is recessive. Violet red flower color is dominant, whereas white flower color is recessive. Flower position axial is dominant, whereas terminal flower color is recessive. Inflated pod shape is dominant, whereas pinched pod shape is recessive. Pod color green is dominant, whereas pod color yellow is recessive. Tall plant is dominant, whereas short plant is recessive. Mendel's crossed pea plant. The diagrammatic representation of Mendel's experiment. At first, he removed the stamens of pea plant bearing purple flowers, then removed the sperm bearing pollen from stamens of white flower to egg bearing carpel of purple flower, then pollinated carpel matured into pod. Then he planted seeds from pod. He observed that in first generation all the offspring were of purple colors. Conclusion of Mendel's research. However, the three conclusions drawn from his research. First is law of dominance. Second, law of segregation. And the third, law of independent assortment. Now let us learn about these laws in detail. First is law of dominance. First of all, we must understand what is the law of dominance. Mendel's law of dominance states that recessive alleles will always be masked by dominant alleles. Therefore, a cross between a homozygous dominant and a homozygous recessive will always express the dominant phenotype while still having a heterozygous genotype. Law of dominance can be explained easily with the help of monohybrid cross experiment. In a cross between two organisms, pair for any pair or pairs of contrasting traits, the character that appears in F1 generation is called dominant, and the one which is suppressed, not expressed, is called recessive. Each character is controlled by a pair of dissimilar factors. Only one of the character expresses. The one which expresses in F1 generation is called dominant. It is the important to note, however, that the law of dominance is significant and true, but is not universally applicable. According to the latest revisions, only two of these laws are considered to be laws. The third one is considered as a basic principle, but not a genetic law of Mendel. Next, we will learn about the law of segregation. Mendel considered monohybrid cross here, that is, only smooth and wrinkled seeds were taken into consideration. It states that the two alleles for a characteristic separate during gamete formation, that is, egg and sperm. Mendel's experiment showed that the factors, that is, dominant or recessive, for the characters in P generation during gametogenesis separate from each other. These factors then coexist in F1 generation, which later reappears in F2 generation in a ratio of 3:1. The law of segregation states that every individual contains a pair of alleles for each particular trait which segregate or separate during cell division, assuming diploidy. For any particular trait, and that each parent passes a randomly selected copy or allele to its offspring. The offspring then receives its own pair of alleles of the gene for that trait by inheriting sets of homologous chromosomes from the parent organism. Interaction between alleles at a single locus are termed dominance, and these influences how the offspring expresses that trait. Example, the color of height of a plant or the color of an animal's fur. More precisely, the law states that any individual produces gametes, the copies of a gene separate, so that each gamete receives only one copy or allele. A gamete will receive one allele or the other. The direct proof of this was later found following the observation of meiosis by two independent scientists, the German biologist Oskar Hartwig and the Belgian zoologist Eduard van Beneden. The parental and maternal chromosomes get separated in meiosis, and the alleles with the traits of a character are segregated into two different gametes. Each parent contributes a single gamete, and thus a single randomly successful allele copy to their offspring and fertilization. The given image shows how Mendel's second law, allele segregate and once again unite. The first figure shows that the alleles of yellow and green plea from pure breeding plant grows into plant. During gamete formation, it segregates from each other. Whereas the second one shows that during fertilization, the segregate alleles unite with each other and lead into development of seed. Let us learn in detail about the law of independent assortment. Mendel considered dihybrid cross, that is, smooth seed and yellow cotyledons, that is, wrinkled seed and green cotyledons. Mendel's third law states that the alleles for different characteristics are distributed to reproductive cells independently. In this experiment, round seed and yellow cotyledon was crossed with wrinkled seed and green cotyledon. The hybrid seeds obtained during F1 generation were all smooth seed and yellow cotyledon, which means that smooth seed was dominant over wrinkled seed, whereas yellow cotyledon was dominant over green cotyledon. The hybrids of F1 generation were self-pollinated, where he obtained 4 different combinations of F2 generation in the ratio of 9:3:3:1, that is smooth yellow 9, smooth green 3, wrinkled yellow 3 and wrinkled green 1. He concluded that alleles for different traits are sought independently of one another. In short, it states that in the inheritance of more than one pair of traits in a cross simultaneously, the factor responsible for each pair of traits are distributed to the gametes. The law of independent assortment, also known as inheritance law, states that separate genes for separate traits are passed independently of one another from parents to offspring. This is the biological selection of a particular gene in the gene pair for one trait to be passed to the offspring has nothing to do with the selection of the gene for any other trait. More precisely, the law states that alleles of different genes are sought independently of one another during gamete formation. While Mendel's experiments with mixing one trait always resulted in a 3:1 ratio between dominant and recessive phenotypes, his experiments with mixing two traits, that is dihybrid cross, showed 9:3:3:1 ratios, but 9:3:3:1 shows that each of the two genes is independently inherited with a 3:1 phenotypic ratio. Mendel concluded that different traits are inherited independently of each other, so that there is no relation, for example, between a cat's color and tail length. This is actually only true for genes that are not linked to each other. Now let us learn about the cross. The cross made between hybrids of F1 generation and one of the parent is called back cross. Back cross is of two types. First is outcross, that is a cross between F1 hybrids and dominant homozygous parents. Second is the test cross. It is a cross between hybrids of F1 generation and recessive homozygous parent. Next is the exception of Mendel's law. The various exceptions arose from Mendel's law were incomplete dominance, codominance, and multiple alleles. Let us learn about these in detail. First is incomplete dominance. Incomplete dominance, also called partial dominance, occurs when the phenotype of the heterozygous genotype is distinct from and often intermediate to the genotypes of the homozygous genotypes. For example, the snapdragon flower color is either homozygous for red or white. When the red homozygous flower is paired with the white homozygous flower, the result yields a pink snapdragon flower. The pink snapdragon is the result of incomplete dominance. A similar type of incomplete dominance is found in the 4 o'clock plant, wherein pink color is produced when true breed parents of white and red flowers are crossed. In quantitative genetics, where phenotypes are measured and treated numerically, if a heterozygous phenotype is exactly between that of the two homozygotes, the phenotype is said to exhibit no dominance at all. That is, dominance exists only when the heterozygous phenotype measure lies closer to one homozygote than the other. When plants of the F1 generation are self-pollinated, the phenotypic and genotypic ratio of the F2 generation will be 1:2:1, that is, red, pink and white for both generations. Next is codominance. Codominance occurs when the contributions of both alleles are visible in the phenotype. Codominance, where allelic products coexist in the phenotype, is different from incomplete dominance, where the quantitative interaction of allele products produces an intermediate phenotype. For example, in codominance, a red homozygous flower and a white homozygous flower will produce offspring that have red and white spots. When plant of the F1 generation are self-pollinated, the phenotypic and genotypic ratio of the F2 generation will be 1:2:1, that is, red spotted white. These ratios are the same as those for incomplete dominance. Again, note that this classical terminology is inappropriate. In reality, such cases should not be said to exhibit dominance at all. Last is multiple alleles. There are 3 or more alleles of the same gene that code for same trait is called as multiple alleles. For example, in human blood, there are 4 groups, that is A, B, AB and O.
Let us now summarize what we have learnt in this module. Gregor Mendel is known as father of genetics. Mendel's research was with P, that is Pisum sativum. Basically, 7 traits were studied by Mendel in pea plants. However, the three conclusions drawn from his research were law of dominance, law of segregation, and law of independent assortment. Mendel's first law states that one allele in pair dominate over other, the one which get unexpressed is called recessive. Mendel's second law that the factors dominant or recessive for the characters in P generation during gametogenesis segregate from each other. Mendel's third law states that the alleles for different characteristics are distributed to reproductive cells independently. The cross made between hybrids of F1 generation and one of the parents is called back cross. Exceptions of Mendel's laws are incomplete dominance, codominance, and multiple alleles. In incomplete dominance, an individual have an intermediate phenotypic effect. Three or more alleles of the same gene that code for the same trait is called as multiple alleles.